Today, I became tired of waiting. I decided if I was going to break free from being stuck, I just had to get started and move forward. I believe I can move past being stuck by working on this project that I've been neglecting for a while, a project that could help me move forward. So I guess I'm going to get started and move forward on this project or get started in this project, and that will help me move forward. Doesn't really matter which. I said to myself, I'm going to start now, and that's all there is to it. There's no time like the present, nothing to it but to do it. You know, it just occurred to me that there's a variation on the saying nothing to it but to do it. You can also say the only way to do it is to do it, or you can say the only way out is through. Doesn't really matter, I can just use whichever version is the most inspiring at the time. Then I started thinking that while it's admirable to have an ambitious project in the works, you know, like finishing a dissertation, writing a novel, or studying for the bar exam, this is also a situation where you can feel a lot of pressure because the outcome of your project determines whether or not you will move forward. So I'm going to try not to feel too much pressure, especially when I'm just getting started. Then I started thinking that the psychology of getting started can be fascinating. A person can hesitate a lot when getting started because your brain tells you that if you make just one tiny little mistake, your whole project will be ruined. You don't want to start your painting because if you do the eyebrows wrong, what could have been a masterpiece will become a disaster. You don't want to start your novel because if you put any commas in the wrong place, people will use the thing as toilet paper. And that's when you know you're overthinking instead of letting your thoughts flow free. And my thoughts need to flow free if I'm going to get started and move forward. You know, it's kind of interesting to think about how your brain may actually find comfort in not finishing a project like this. I mean, if your project isn't done yet, you obviously don't know how the thing is going to turn out, and so you can happily daydream that your project will be awesome when it's done. But once you finish it, that daydream is over, and you may have to face the fact that your project is a total piece of shit. I guess it's a defense mechanism, but it's also a trap, and a trap that I do not want to fall into if I'm going to get started and move forward. Yeah, I'm just going to get started and move forward. Next time on Stuck, we will explore the particular significance of your bed when you're stuck. Tune in and find out what the hell I'm talking about. This series is funded entirely by viewers like you. You can chip in too at my Patreon page here. Share and enjoy.